สวัสดีค่ะ Hello everyone Welcome back to Banana Thai again with Crew Smoke And ยินดีต้อนรับนะคะทุกคนสู่ Live Thai Lesson Really welcome everyone And greeting from my hometown Cha Chiang Sao As you can see in the back still green I'm not yet in Bangkok I'm still you know outside of Bangkok Please do let me know where exactly you are watching me from SoSending regard to everyone right now. And today's topic, I will be talking about five Thai particles. If you would like to improve your Thai speaking skill, if you want to speak like a native Thai, want to speak naturally, you must know Thai particles. And today I'm going to talk about five particles. Are you ready, everyone? Is everyone ready for it?So, before we start together, I would like to promote a group for you. Here you go, this group. Live Thai Lesson exclusive group because I'm not gonna be, you know, have availability to teach you every week on live on my Facebook like this, but I'm gonna move this last session to my private exclusive group.And there you will be learning with me and you will join an active Thai learning community where everyone is active and want to contribute to this community. Besides, you will be joining me for the weekly live Thai lesson like this and you will also get downloadable PDF file of my slide that I used to teach you one day before. So you can print it out and you can use it to writeThings down like a note when you see me live. So let me know, contact me to join. นะคะ This is very exclusive. นะคะ Just contact me. Alrighty. So if everyone is ready, we can continue with Thai particles. Everything is good. สวัสดีค่ะ Hi, คุณ John. Hi, คุณ Renato, Stefan. Everyone, thank you so much for joining. So let's start with this.What is a particle? What is a particle? So let me maybe like put a little bit of video here so you can see me here as well. Alrighty. Good. So what is particle exactly? Particle are the words that put at the end of the sentence to make the speechwith some particular tone, sound, emotion, or feeling. Something that imply what you want to say. For example, the main particle that you know are ka, krap. These two are polite particle that put at the end of the sentence to make the sentence polite. But besides these two, there are much more. There are more than 20. More than 20 of...Thai particles, นะคะ And today I will show you the five most commonly used one and how to use them properly. Alright? Oh, good. So let's continue with the next slide. Here you go. Here are the example of the Thai particle. The first one, สวัสดีค่ะ The first one is สวัสดีค่ะสวัสดีค่ะ So สวัสดี สวัสดี actually mean hello. So if you put the word ค่ะ or ครับ สวัสดีค่ะ สวัสดีครับ If you put this ค่ะ or ครับ at the end, it make the sentence polite. นะคะ Next one, ไม่เอานะ Maybe you have heard people say นะ Thai people like to say นะ นะคะ นะจ๊ะ นะนะนะ So we will beLearning about this word as well. Next one, ไม่ดีเลย ไม่ดีเลย Oh, what is the word เลย ไม่ดีเลย ไม่สวยเลย ไม่อร่อยเลย ไม่ชอบเลย เลย also เลย is also a particle. Next one, อะไรวะ อะไรวะ what is also a particle. อะไรวะ you might have heard this phrase already. อะไรวะNext one. Okay, I think I'm gonna close my screen because it's kind of slow. So, by C. C. In this case, also a particle. So, these are an example of the particle that you commonly use in your life. So, let's continue with the first one. Ka. K. ka, krap. What are these? Many people ask me, why do you have to say ka or krap? And what exactly it mean, huh? What exactly it mean? So, what exactly ka, krap mean? Basically, ka, krap, or ka, both of them, all of them doesn't have any meaning. They don't have meaning. That's why they're particle. And it put at the end of the sentence to make the sentence polite. That's why it's called polite particle. Ah, polite particle. Whatever that end with the word ka, krap ka, it's polite. It gives you a polite, okay? For example, here are the example. First one, A ask, kun tam arai yu ka? Kun tam arai yu ka? You put the word ka at the end. You put the word ka at the end. It's make the sentence much more nicer. If you ask, kun tam arai yu, it's mean, what are you doing? What are you doing? Kun tam arai yu. But if you put the word ka at the end, it makes it sound so nice. So what are you doing? Tam arai yu ka. And the second one. Chan kin kao yu ka. Chan kin kao yu ka. I am eating, but you put the word ka at the end. It makes the sentence much nicer. It makes the sentence really polite and nice. Alright, so if you put ka, ka, krap at the end of the sentence, it makes the sentence nice. So, I'm gonna close my camera again, so it's not gonna be lacking anymore. So, next one. One thing that I'll have to mention to you. What are the differences between these two words? Ka and ka. If you see the way it write, it is different. So ka without my a and ka with my a. Now, this is called my a, this thing is called my a. So the word ka, high tone, ka, ka, rising tone, ka, ka, this one you use it for question. It's a question word. Alright, it's a question word. While the word ka, the sounds go down low tone, ka, ka, it's just used for statement and negative sentence. Here you go. The differences between ka and ka. Got it? If you got it, give me some likes. Give me some likes so I know that you got it. Very good. Very good. Just to remind you one more time. Ka and ka. You can always say krap, ka, ka. In any sentence to make the sentence nice. All right, it is different in the tone of the word ka, used for question word, and ka, low tone, used for statement and negative. Next one, the word na. Na. Many people know the word na. Have you heard the word na before? Na, na. ทำอะไรอยู่นะ อยากกินข้าวนะ หิวนะจะไปดูหนังนะ everything with the word na. So what does it mean? Na is used only for a statement that include negative. So statement and negative. You will never ever use the word na for question. You will never say คุณหิวหรือเปล่านะ. You can also say, but na is more like giving a feeling of to inform someone something. You give an information. For example, the first one. ผมไม่หิวนะ. ผมไม่หิวนะ. What does it mean? What does it mean? ผมไม่หิวนะ. ผมไม่หิวนะ. The word หิว, what does it mean? หิว mean hungry. ผมไม่หิวนะ mean am not hungry. You can also say ผมไม่หิว as I'm not hungry. But if you want to give the feeling of, you know, being friendly, being cute, you would use the word นะ. ผมไม่หิวนะ. It's cuter, believe me. Use the word นะ, it's cute. But it's a little bit feminist, I would say. It's a little bit feminist. It's soft, nice, friendly, and a little bit feminist. Next one, next example. ฉันอิ่มแล้วนะ. What does it mean คะ? ฉ ันอิ่มแล้วนะฉันอิ่มแล้วนะ The word อิ่ม is the opposite word of the word หิว อิ่ม means full Full ฉันอิ่มแล้วนะ I'm full alreadyI am full already. Ah, here you go. I am full already. Let me make it big for you. Make it big, make it big. Here. ฉันอิ่มแล้วนะ I'm trying to tell you. I'm trying to inform you that I'm full already. That's why I use the word นะ. So the word นะ used for statement, negative statement, just to give the feeling of being cute, being friendly.Besides, the word na can also use to request something. The word na can also be used to request something. All right. For example, ไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ ไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ If you use the word na at the end, it also means you want to request, you want to ask somebody to do something for you. Na.Nah, like this. Thai people like to do it. Nah, 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 nah. It's like, please, 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 please. The first one. ไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ When you say nah, you have to do the face like this. Nah. ไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ What does it mean, ka, everyone? ไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ The word ดูหนัง means do is to watch. And หนัง is movie. So to watch a movie.ไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ with me กับฉัน with me and you put the word na at the end I make it hard for you to make it like please นะไปดูหนังกับฉันนะ next question oh sorry next example กินข้าวด้วยกันนะกินข้าวด้วยกันนะ Not again. When you want to request, when you want to convince nicely, you use the word นะกินข้าวด้วยกัน What does it mean คะกินข้าวด้วยกัน means eat together. And when you put the word นะ you try to convince. Like, please eat together. Eat together, please. นะ here you go. Got it or not? You got it?If you got it, put the like for me. If you got it, put the like for me so I know. Any question for the word na? Na for two things. To inform something and to request a convince nicely. Alrighty. Very good. As you can see, you know, this particle doesn't have any meaning. It's just like the word that you put it and just make the sentence sound specific.Thing like specific way. So let's continue the third one. This one is also really commonly used, but maybe some Thai learner have not yet like seen it. It's quite people, you know, I understand Thai people when they talk quite fast. So that's why you might skip this word. กินข้าวสิ the word สิ sounds go down. สิ together, speak together. พูดด้วยกันค่ะSee. See. You use the word see at the end of the sentence as an imperative sentence. If you want to order, command, well, the word see, it's not giving, it's not, you know, make the person feel like, nah, like I'm begging you, I ask you nicely, but it's more like, do it, eat, go, sit.You know, it's more like demanding, like it's imperative. For example, กินข้าวสิ The word กินข้าว means to eat. And when you put the word สิ it's like to suggest you to do something. Like eat. It's a little bit impolite, I would say. Because it's more like not really nice to like eat. You better say กินนะOr you can make the word si nice when you put the word ka. กินสิคะ กินสิครับ make the word si nice with the polite particle. See, you can use two particle together. สิคะ สิครับ when you want to, you know, suggest or ask somebody to do something nicely, put the word ka or ครับ So, กินข้าวสิ it's like eat. Eat.กินข้าวสิคะ Oh, eat. Ah, it's different, huh? Second one. Pood pro see. Pood pro see. Ah, the word pood. What does it mean, ka pood? Pood. Pood means to speak. Ah. Pood means to speak. Ah. Pro. What does it mean, pro? Anyone know the word pro? Pro is like nicely, and you use the word pro for speaking, for reading, not for reading, for speaking, for giving speech, for singing. Ah, so the word pro is an adverb, like nicely, for speaking and singing. Put pro see is like speak nicely. Don't be rude to me. Don't say it like that. Put pro see. Ah, speak nicely. Ah, and you put the word see at the end of the sentence when you want to command or demand something. Alrighty? Any question for this? No question? Alright, so let's continue. The word see, beside of imperative, the word see can also to emphasize something. Ah, let me give you example how to use the word see to emphasize. So A asks, tuang, babe, the word tuang, it's like babe in Thai, na. Tuang, rak khao mai ya, rak khao mai. Do you love me? รักเขาไหม รักผมไหม or รักฉันไหม also work นะ but เขา is cute นะ รักเขาไหม and B say รักสิ oh I emphasize I do love you รักสิ if I say รัก it means I love รักสิ I do love you นะคะรักมากรักสิรักมาก I do love you I love you very much nah so you can use the word see to emphasize something like DC chop see I really like it I do like it รักสิ I do love it อร่อยสิ it is really delicious so use the word see.To emphasize. See many times that Thai people use the particle and they have no meaning. You cannot even Google it, like how, like the meaning of the word, but it gives a specific feeling or specific implication with that sentence. So that's it. So let's continue with the fourth one. Whew, how is it going?You all like it? I think it's really it's really good to improve listening and speaking, especially when you have Thai friends and they speak like freely. They speak, you know, they don't really care whether you understand it or not. They use a lot of particle. So let's continue. Number four, the word wah. Wah. Look at my face when I said it. Wah.I become serious. I become fierce. Wah. The word wah is impolite particle. So it's opposite to the word ka and krap. The word ka and krap are polite particle. And the word wah is impolite particle. So let's see it quickly here. For example...I think everyone have heard this phrase. Thai people like to say like, Alewa, Alewa, like this, Alewa. It's like, what, but like, what? When you don't really get something, when you don't really understand something or something get confusing for you, you say, Alewa, what? Next one, you can use with another, like other, the WS question word like ที่ไหนที่ไหนวะ hey คุณจะไปเที่ยวที่ไหนวะ คุณ the word the word คุณ is too nice you say แกจะไปเที่ยวที่ไหนวะ talk to friend นะ hey แกจะไปเที่ยวที่ไหนวะ where well it's more like a, where the heck you know where the you know like where where you want to go. Very impolite, but it could also be used with friends because it's casual. Next one. Tamai wa. What is the word tamai? Tamai means why. Why the heck? Sorry. Like, tamai wa? Mai kao zai ya. Tamai wa? I don't understand. Why is it? Tamai kao mai rak chan na? Why he doesn't like me? Tamai wa? Why? So you use the word wa with question word when you kind of pissed off, when you just get confused, you don't want to be polite anymore. All right. Is everything good? All righty. Very good. You say why the heck, Kunhana too. Yes, it's more like that. It's give the feeling like why the heck, you know. Sorry, not, but it's true. You use the word wa. The word wa, not only used with question word, like WS question word. It can also use with yes, no question word or even statement or negative. Let's see this example. Guy say, Mung chop gin bia ni pa wa? So sorry that I speak not nice at all. Mung, the word mung. Maybe you haven't heard about it. Mung is you. You, but impolite. Okay, let's say casual and impolite. So many Thai people, especially young ones, use the word mung to call friends. Like, oi, mung tham alai wa? What are you doing? Dude. Like this, you know, more like not really formal. So, mung chop gin bia ni bao wa? The word bao is yes, no, question word. It's like the word mai, nah? Bao wa? Bao wa is like, huh? Give you a feeling of a huh? But not really nice, nah? Impolite, huh? For example, hey, hiu pa wa? Are you hungry? But saying it in a very casual way. Hey, aloy pa wa? Is it delicious? But in a very casual way. So, one person asks, mung chop gin bia ni pa wa? Do you really like to drink this beer? Huh? And another person answer, gu mai chop gin bia nia mai aroy wa. The word gu is I, can be used for both male and female speaker. The word gu can be used for both male and female speaker. So gu is I, but casual, impolite. I mean, can be used with friends, but not really with people that you respect. So gu mai chop gin, I don't like to eat, I don't like to drink. Bia nia mai aroy wa, this beer is not delicious. You can see from this conversation, you don't really need the word wa at all. You can cut it and it still sound the same, but it just, you know, lack of the emotion. The word wa give the emotion of being casual, being like emotional. The word wa. So both way to use the word wa. Wa for impolite particle with question word, and wa with statement here. Wa. All right, all good? Any question? Many people never heard the word wa. I understand. I mean, I sometimes say it, but normally I don't really say it. But it's kind of necessary sometimes to say, because you feel like, huh? Ale wa? So let's continue to the last one. The word noi. Noi. This is how to write it, and this is how you read it for romanized version. Noi. The word noi, or you can say noi for almost every sentence, like kokin noi. Pai duikan noi. Kokin khonom noi. Noi. And noi, well, the word noi give the feeling of being like, like a, you know, like not lower than another person, but more like asking when you want to ask for a favor, when you want to ask for permission, you use the word noi. Ah, noi actually means small or little. So if you put the word noi at the end of the sentence, it's more like for a little bit. For a little bit, please. Let's see that example, and I will use the word ขอ noi, may I have. May I have ขอ noi. For example, ขอกินขนมหน่อย. If you say ขอกินขนม, it's like I would like to eat snack. But if you put the word noi at the end, it gives a very nice feeling like please. I don't want you to translate the word noi as please, because it's not please. Noi, the word please can be other word as well, but it's a particle that gives the feeling of like please, like the word na, like ขอกินขนมหน่อยนะ, ขอกินขนมนะ, ขอกินขนมหน่อย. It's similar, นะคะ. So ขอกินขนมหน่อย mean may I eat some snack, and then I put the word please at the end, so it's, you know, polite and cute. The next example, ขอเข้าห้องน้ำหน่อย. If you go to other people's house, like for Thai culture, we always ask the owner of the house, the host, like, may I go to the toilet? Because Thai people will not just like get in the house and let's go to the toilet. You always ask, nah? It's like, how to say, it's like a cultural thing, you know, you considerate about it. So if you want to go to the toilet of your friend's house, you would ask the owner or your friends, ขอเข้าห้องน้ำหน่อย. The word หน่อย is here. ห้องน้ำ, what does it mean? ห้องน้ำ is toilet or bathroom, exactly. And เข้าห้องน้ำ, เข้า mean to get in, like to use to get in. ขอเข้าห้องน้ำหน่อย. May I get in the toilet? Like, may I use your toilet? Please, หน่อย at the end. If you say ขอเข้าห้องน้ำ, it's fine, but use the word หน่อย when you want to ask for a permission. All right, any question? Last example, you can use the word ให้หน่อย. ให้หน่อย. You can use with the word ช่วย, but just cut it out. Just think about ให้หน่อย. If you put the word ให้หน่อย at the end of the sentence, it's like you ask somebody for a favor to do something for you. Let me break this word for you. ให้หน่อย. The word ให้ is for. So ให้หน่อย is like for me. Actually, it should be ให้ฉันหน่อย or ให้ผมหน่อย. But it's okay. You cut it out. Thai people like to cut things short. So ให้หน่อย means for me. For me and please. See, I don't want you to translate it as please, but it's give you a feeling of like please, นะคะ. ให้หน่อย. For example, ซื้อกาแฟ. Let's start with this phrase first. ซื้อกาแฟ. What does it mean? คะซื้อกาแฟ Type down. ซื้อกาแฟ. ซื้อกาแฟ. What is the word? ซื้อกาแฟ. What does it mean? ซื้อกาแฟ. ซื้อ mean to buy. กาแฟ is coffee.Buy coffee, ซื้อกาแฟ, buy coffee. But if you put the word ให้หน่อย at the end, here you go. It's like you ask for a favor for someone to do something for you. So ซื้อกาแฟให้หน่อย literally means please buy me a coffee. ซื้อกาแฟให้ฉันหน่อย. ซื้อกาแฟให้ผมหน่อย or cut it ซื้อกาแฟให้หน่อย This is really commonly used นะ the word ให้หน่อย You know I would really recommend you to try out all of these particles That would be funny to see the reaction And you will never believe that it's really changed your lifechange the way of speaking. You speak much more like Thai, much more like native speaker. All right, so the next one. สอนภาษาไทย. Let's start with this one. สอนภาษาไทย. What does it mean คะสอนภาษาไทย? สอนภาษาไทย. The word สอน is to teach. ภาษาไทย is Thai language. สอนภาษาไทย. TeachThai language or teach Thai. If you put the word hai noi, it means please for me, please. So, sorn pa sa Thai hai noi means please teach me Thai. Here you go. My microphone. All good. Any question? I'm very excited. One question from Kun Fred. Kun Fred asked me, "Is Hai Noi SMS? Do you mind too?" No, it's not really exactly like "Do you mind to do something," but it's more like, as I say, it's more like to ask for a favor to do something for me. Well, can you say it in English? Like, would you mind teaching me Thai? Yeah.But the answer would be, yeah, I don't mind, I can do it. But for me, I would translate the word hai noi means like, can you? It's not like, would you mind, but like, can you teach me? Can you do it for me? I'm asking for a favor. Would you be so kind to buy some coffee for me, please? Wow, Andre, very good. That is exactly what it is. Because when you use the word hai noi, you are so polite.Really, for real? So that's it. So let's do summary quickly and do short quiz together. If you understand this, if you like this lesson, give me some likes. Put some likes so I see that you like it. I know you like it. So to summarize this, first one, ka and krap, both of them are polite particle.Can use these two particles anytime, but be careful with ka and ka. Ka, high tone. Ka is a particle for question. Question. อะไรคะ While the word ka, ka, low tone, for statement and negative. Next one. Na, it's more like please. You want to inform something to someone. Like you know, I want to tell you about this.Please note this, but it's a cute one. Na, or if you make it long, na, please. All right, next one. C and D, use when you know, for imperative. Imperative sentence. Oi, gin si. I forgot to mention the word D. D is even like more casual than the word C. Like,กินซี่ is like eat กินดี it's very like impolite like eat this you know like so C impolite D very impolite next one wa is emotional it's emotional particle it's impolite though impolite and emotional For example, like, อะไรวะ What the heck? ทำไมวะ Why the... Sorry, I don't wanna... Yeah, but you know what I wanted to say, right? So, wa is an impolite one. Last one, noi. Give you a very nice feeling when you want to ask for a favor or when you want to ask for a permission. Alright? If you want to ask for a permission...You use the word noi. All right, that's it for today. Let's continue with our quiz together. So all of this slide with notes, I will post it in the group lessons. Here, the exclusive live Thai lesson, I will post it there. So if you join, you will be able to see all of these notes. Alrighty, so let me turn on the next one. Blank. Here you go. Let's test Thai together. Whether you understand it or not. So if I say, I give you one phrase like hiu, chan hiu, so small, chan hiu. What does it mean, ka? Chan hiu? Anyone? Chan hiu. Chan hiu is I am hungry. If you want to say it politely, you will say chan hiu ka or krap. Polite. I'm gonna use the word chan hiu with all of the particle. Next one. If you want to say chan hiu na, if you say chan hiu na, it's like, hey, please note. Please note, I'm hungry. By the way, I'm hungry. Chan hiu na. You want to confirm, you want to inform, nah? Next one. Chan hiu. Chan hiu si. Chan hiu si. Si, in this case, normally I tell you as an imperative, but si could also mean, you know, to, how to say, to emphasize. Chan hiu si. It's mean I am hungry. I am really hungry. Like I do feel hungry. I do feel hungry. I am hungry. Use the word si to emphasize. If you say chan hiu wa, it started to get emotional. Like I'm freaking hungry. All right, use the word "wa." It's impolite. And then last one. Chan hiu noi doesn't work because the word noi, it's more like to ask for, write down for you first. Chan hiu noi doesn't work because the word noi, it's more like, you know, please, I am hungry, please, doesn't work. So in this case, doesn't work. So you can see with the sentence chan hiu, it can be used with most of these particles and it gives you different feeling. See, this is an example how to use it. All right, all good? Any question for today? Very good, you guys. Good job, geng mak mak na ka. And thank you so much for, you know, being like supportive and join my Facebook live session all the time. I'm very, very happy for it. So that's it for today. So let me turn on my camera here. So as I say, you know, because there are so many people text me and I have a lot of inbox and messages and emails asking for things, especially from the live session, I would be really happy to continue doing live session, but it's gonna be once a month instead of every week. But if you want to join this live session like this, every week you can join my Thai Live Thai lesson exclusive group. Please DM me. But one thing that I have to tell you is that they're gonna be a small fee of 100 baht a month. It's gonna be monthly subscription, only 100 baht. And you will be able to join my live session 4 to 5 times a month and you will get the slide that you can print it out and you can note it down and you will also get the notes, like all of these notes here, like that I use for you, that I show you. So all of these notes you will also get with my, you know, writing, with my explanation, everything. So I know, like, you know, I don't want to make it like this, but it's good for me to create the community that focus on people who really want to learn. So, you know, please join me, let me know, DM me. if you are interested. For today, I have to go now. If you have any question, just leave it here. If I have time, I will come back to you very soon. Alrighty. Thank you so much for today. ขอบคุณมากๆนะคะ ขอบคุณมากๆนะคะ I use the word ค่ะ Joy group lesson กับครูสมุกนะ Please join my group lesson group the Life Thai lesson group นะ Please for today that's it I will see youNext month for the live lesson, and I will see you who joined the group next week again on Friday. เจอกันค่ะ Bye bye. ขอบคุณค่ะ Don't forget to DM me if you want to join that group. Bye bye. ไปก่อนค่ะ